Dear Chairperson, renowned personalities on the dais, and my dear brothers and sisters, beloved students, andariki hrudayapurvaka namaskaramalu. I don't know Telugu. I'm going to speak in English. At the outset, let me register my word of appreciation to Honorable Chief Minister Sri Chandrababu Naidu to organize such a historic event here, which give us inspiration to fight for the women's equality all over the country. I thanks to Andhra Pradesh Legislative Assembly, Andhra Pradesh Government, and also my Smith School, and also who supported us to conduct this great event, that is Commonwealth Parliamentary Association. 69 years have passed after our independence. But what is the fate of women folk in India? Women are suffering in three ways in India nowadays also. Women are suffering as women, and women are suffering as a citizen, and women are suffering as worker also. In these three fields, women are facing several atrocities and difficulties, inequalities, etc. In our constitution, we assured women in India equal opportunity. In the preamble of our constitution itself, it is written, our country is democratic, secular, and socialist. India is a democratic, secular, and socialist republic. But what is meant by democracy? Greek philosophers said, democracy doesn't mean the accommodation of Tom or Harry to the office. It means perfect equality in opportunity. If it is so, we should examine whether Indian women are getting equal opportunity. Yes, women, because of the gender bias, they are suffering very much. Each moment they are being raped and kidnapping. Every kinds of atrocities are happened because they are women. The society is counted them for women only. And as a citizen, she cannot enjoy the assurance of the constitution. She cannot enjoy the right. She cannot enjoy the opportunity. And she is suffering very much. And as a worker, she is harassed at the workplace. Each moment, she is ridiculed at the workplace.